On one end of the spectrum is complete black, on other end of the spectrum is complete white, and in between are lesser blacks and lesser whites. In any given X-ray, 4 to 5 basic densities can be appreciated. On one end of the spectrum that is black, that is air. Air in the lung parenchyma. So less black or grayish is the fat. Fat in the subcutaneous tissues in the chest wall. Less white, soft tissues like heart, fluid or liver and diaphragm. Then white, which corresponds to metal, that is calcium in the bones. And very bright, that is completely metal like a foreign object, this marker. So five basic densities are black, that is air, less black, that is fat, less white, that is soft tissues like heart, muscle or blood or fluid, then white like calcium in bones, very bright metallic foreign objects. Now if X-ray image is shown to you, don't jump towards diagnosis. Take at least 1 minute to read the film. A systematic approach will help you in reaching the diagnosis. Either have inside out or outside inward approach. Always compare both right and the left sides as unilateral abnormalities, bilateral asymmetrical or symmetrical abnormalities will help to narrow down the list of differential diagnoses. After you have found where the abnormality is, think of the site and most common pathology you know that can affect that site. Remember, rare diseases are rarely asked in the practical. So we begin with the outside inwards approach. That is, we start by looking at the chest wall, then pleural cavity, then lung parenchyma, then mediastinum and the heart. So let's begin with the chest wall. So in chest wall, look for the subcutaneous fat and bony thorax. This is the subcutaneous fat and the chest wall soft tissues. So most commonly asked disease is surgical emphysema, which is seen in patients with trauma with rib fractures. So here is an X-ray in which this is the normal side. There is no air, and on this side there is air in the subcutaneous tissues reaching up to the neck. So this is surgical emphysema. Whenever there is surgical emphysema, you should be alerted about the underlying rib fracture or pneumothorax. Now after the soft tissues, we go towards the bony thorax. In bony thorax, you should look for the scapula, the clavicle. If humeral head is visible, then you can look for it also. And the ribs, the vertebral bodies. So here is an X-ray in which there is surgical emphysema, multiple rib fractures and lung contusions. And here is an X-ray in which there is the fracture of a clavicle. Now coming more inwards, we go for pleural cavity. Most commonly asked pathologies are pleural effusion, that is blunting of CP angle. There is opacity in the CP angle. Instead of a sharp margin, there is a rising fluid levels along the chest wall. So this is the typical pleural effusion. Now if there is massive pleural effusion, the hemithorax will be completely opaque, white out lung or opaque hemithorax. It will cause mass effect and shift of mediastinum, that is trachea, and heart or cardiac apex towards contralateral side. So a massive pleural effusion, there is a mediastinal shift. Now next in pleural cavity after pleural effusion is pneumothorax. Remember, air is completely black on X-ray. So if the cavity is black, pleural cavity is black, and there are no bronchovascular markings, so it means there is a pneumothorax. Now if there is pneumothorax, the visceral pleural layer is pushed inwards, so we can see the visceral pleural layer. So the two signs of pneumothorax are absence of bronchovascular markings in a black area and visible visceral pleura. So this is the sign of pneumothorax. And now opposite of white out lung, that is black out lung, there is massive pneumothorax. And in this massive pneumothorax, there is shift of mediastinum towards the opposite side. So this gives the tension pneumothorax. If there is shift of mediastinum towards contralateral side, that is tension pneumothorax. If there is no shift, then it's simple pneumothorax. Now, next thing in pleural cavity is, after pleural effusion and pneumothorax, is that both of the things, that is hydro pneumothorax, can be present in the pleural cavity. So how it will look? It will look like air in the pleural cavity as well as effusion in the pleural cavity with air fluid levels. So this is hydro pneumothorax. Now, another X-ray that can be presented is the treatment of this hydro pneumothorax or pneumothorax, that is done by inserting a chest tube. So this is the chest tube which is inserted over here in the pneumothorax. This will help in the treatment of the patient. Now, moving more inwards is the lung parenchyma. So in after pleura, there will be lung parenchyma. So in lung parenchyma, that is, there can be increased density or there can be decreased density or there can be mixed density lesions. Now, in increased density lesions, there can be consolidation, there can be collapse, there can be interstitial disease, there can be nodules or mass. In decreased density, there can be emphysema or cavitation, and third is the mixed density lesions. Now, coming on to lung parenchyma, the most common pathology asked is pneumonia or consolidation. The key findings are, first is a opacity. There is a large opacity in the right upper zone. Second is the Silhouette sign, that is loss of interface with the surrounding soft tissue structures. So there is loss of interface of this opacity with the mediastinum. Third is the air bronchograms, that is the bronchi or the bronchioles or the airway, it is visible within the large opacity. Fourth is that the opacity is bounded either by pleura or the fissures, and it does not cross the pleura or the fissures. And the last is, there is no volume loss or mediastinal shift. The mediastinum remains in the midline. There is no volume loss. It is bounded by the fissure or the pleura. There are air bronchograms. There is Silhouette sign and there is a opacity. So the types of pneumonia which can be seen on X-ray are, either it is a lobar pneumonia, like here it is a right upper lobe pneumonia, complete consolidation. Second is the multifocal pneumonia or bronchopneumonia. There is one patch of pneumonia here. There is an opacity with air bronchogram. There are few smaller patches in the right lower zone. So this is a multifocal bronchopneumonia. And the third is the diffuse pneumonias, which are seen in heart failure, like bat wing appearance, which we'll be discussing in the end. Now, in lung parenchyma, after consolidation, increased density can be due to collapse or atelectasis. It is of two types. First is passive, like in pneumothorax or in effusion. There is a mass effect of effusion or the pneumothorax causing the collapse of the left lung. The active collapse or atelectasis, it is due to the obstruction of the airway. Now, it is similar to consolidation, but there are differences which helps us to differentiate between the collapse and the consolidation. Now, in collapse, there is a opacity. Just like consolidation, there is opacity in the right upper lung. Second, just like consolidation, there is loss of interface between the opacity and the mediastinum. But the difference, main difference between consolidation and collapse is, there is loss of air bronchograms. The air bronchograms are absent. Fourth is, it is again bounded by the pleura or the fissure. But the other major difference is that it causes the volume loss, which causes the ipsilateral shift of mediastinum or the structures towards towards the collapse. So there is shift of the horizontal fissure towards the right upper lung. There is shift of trachea towards the right upper lung. So the main difference between collapse and consolidation is that there is absence of bronchograms and there is volume loss causing ipsilateral shift of the structures towards the opacity. Now, the third thing in the lung parenchyma causing increased density after consolidation and collapse is the nodules or the mass. So here are the multiple small nodules scattered in the both lungs. So these are very well defined nodular lesions. This is typical of a metastasis. So, and now in this X-ray, there is a large mass with ill-defined or irregular speculated margins. There is area of consolidation like here, there is area of collapse like here, and it is not recognizing the boundaries of the fissures. So this is most likely a bronchogenic carcinoma, an ill-defined large mass with irregular margins which is not considering the boundaries of the lungs. It is a bronchogenic carcinoma. Now in lung parenchyma there is increased density, we have covered. Now it is decreased density. In decreased density is because of emphysema. There is hyperinflated lungs. These are hyperinflated lungs with flattened hemidiaphragm. There is reduced density of the lungs. See, it is more black as compared to a normal X-ray. There are widely spaced ribs. The ribs are very, very widely spaced. The distance between the two ribs is increased. And there is a barrel-shaped chest. So this is a typical of emphysema. Now, decreased lung parenchymal density can also be due to cavity or mixed lesion. So in this X-ray, there are multiple cavitating lesions in the surrounding fibrosis or consolidation in both the upper lobes. So this is a typical of a post-primary tuberculosis. Now again, a similar kind of X-ray with multiple cavitating lesions with surrounding fibrosis, consolidation and volume loss in both mid zones. Another typical X-ray, there is cavitating lesion here, cavitating lesion here, cavitating lesion here, surrounded by fibrocalcific lesions with the volume loss causing upward shift of the horizontal fissure and mediastinum shift towards the right side. So this is again a typical of a post-primary tuberculosis. Now in lung parenchyma, another X-ray showing a well-defined, rounded, thick-walled cavitating lesion with air fluid levels. This is typical of a pulmonary abscess. Now coming more inwards, we should look for the hilae and the mediastinum. In mediastinum, we have to look for the trachea, the bronchi, the cardiovascular shadow, any midline shift, the size of the heart, and any masses in the mediastinum like lymph nodes. Remember, the normal cardiothoracic ratio is less than 50%. And if it is more than 50%, then we term it as cardiomegaly. Now, in cardiomegaly, if there is diffuse enlargement of the heart, giving a money bag appearance, this means there is a massive pericardial effusion. Other causes of cardiomegaly can be the enlargement of the chambers. Now, if the apex that is formed by the left ventricle, it is displaced laterally and points downwards. This means there is a left ventricular hypertrophy and this is left ventricular configuration and it is like a schmoo. So it is called schmoo sign. If there is right ventricular enlargement, the apex will be uplifted. So instead of down and out apex, in right ventricular enlargement, there is upliftment of the cardiac apex. Now see, in this X-ray, there is enlarged right ventricle as there is upliftment of the cardiac apex. Now you all know tetralogy of Fallot, the boot-shaped heart. So there is right ventricular configuration where the apex is lifted upwards. Cause of cardiomegaly can be left atrial enlargement, which is typically seen in mitral stenosis. So we'll be discussing about mitralized heart. The two most important signs are the double density sign and the splaying of carina. So in a mitralized heart, that is due to mitral stenosis, there will be left atrial enlargement, which is seen as the double density sign, because the left atrium becomes visible, superimposed or even beyond the normal right heart border. The other sign is the splaying of carina. The normal carinal angle is acute, but with the enlargement of the left atrium, there is widening of the carina, giving a obtuse carinal angle rather than an acute angle. The third sign is the flat or convex left heart border because of the left atrial enlargement. Now, because of mitral stenosis, there is left atrial enlargement and there are back pressure changes in the lungs. So there will be pulmonary edema and ultimately resulting in pulmonary artery hypertension. So now we'll be discussing about pulmonary edema. Now, one of the main causes of pulmonary edema is the congestive cardiac failure. So, signs of pulmonary edema and congestive cardiac failure will be almost similar on the X-ray. The first sign will be there is increased cardiothoracic ratio or cardiomegaly. The second earliest sign will be the redistribution of the blood flow in the lung parenchyma. There will be cephalization of the blood vessels. Third is because of the increased back pressure, there is leakage of fluid in the pulmonary interstitium, and this results in the curly B lines. These are small, thin, horizontal lines in the peripheral lung, and it represents the fluid in the interstitium, that is in the interlobular septa. Now, with increasing back pressure changes, the fluid will enter the alveolar airspace. So, there will be alveolar airspace opacification, which will result in typical perihilar opacities known as bat wing appearance. These are bilateral typical perihilar opacities giving bat wing appearance. Now, after this, there will be diffuse consolidations and there can be pleural effusion. So, the signs of pulmonary edema and congestive cardiac failure on X-ray are cardiomegaly, cephalization of blood vessels, curly.